everybody, and welcome to another repair video. In today's video, I'll be showing you how I was able to replace a thermistor on my 3D printer and finally fixed ongoing issues with my printer. Now, a quick disclaimer that this video wasn't sponsored by Anycubic, and to do this modification at your own risk. So before anyone asks, I have been having issues with this machine for a very long time. Unlike my first i3 Mega, this one has been prone to stopping randomly, and although I've replaced quite a few components and updated the firmware, the issues have persisted. While most issues were from the prints failing to complete, on this occasion, things were quite different. The print bed temperatures were fluctuating quite drastically, which prevented the print from starting. I had replaced the motherboard in the past, updated the firmware, placed the SD card reader, and rechecked the wiring, so I was fairly certain that these weren't the issues. So I unscrewed the build plate and began double checking the resistance with a multimeter. The first thing I noticed was that the thermistor was completely black, which could be normal, however, I still decided to double check. So the resistance rating for most of these thermistors is normally 100K, but I was reading some strange numbers. Also, you want to make sure that the print bed is fully cooled down prior to taking your measurements, since this seems to affect the readouts. I also noticed that the readings weren't the same once re-soldered together, so that'll be something you want to keep in mind. While desoldering, I noticed that the old solder wasn't coming off easily, even after adding flux. I suspected that the heat bed was helping to diffuse the heat, so I preheated the surface, but that wasn't enough. I ended up adding some fresh solder to the connection along with some flux, which then allowed me to use the solder wick to remove the material from the connection points. Once I removed the old thermistor, I noticed that there was a small hole where the thermistor was located. With the black coating, it's difficult to see, so here's a small diagram to show you what it looked like. I did need to shape the wires slightly to make sure that they would align correctly. However, everything soldered together nicely. After testing it, the resistance seemed better than before, but I wasn't entirely sure that it had worked since I wasn't getting the same results as when I tested the thermistor prior to soldering it into place. I decided to put the machine back together and do a final test. When everything was put back together, I began running the test print. I had outfitted this machine with a 0.8 nozzle since it was originally used for printing large functional parts. The first print didn't look good in the beginning, however the temperatures quickly stabilized and stopped fluctuating irregular after the first print. All follow-up prints had stable temperatures. This also got me thinking about what might be the issue with this machine. When I began hitting a reset button for the machine, all issues stopped when starting a new print. So I began experimenting with the G-code a bit, and after trying out the G99 command and a couple of others, I decided to compare it with another machine's settings. This is where I discovered that there were some extra lines of code and decided to copy and paste the NG code for my CR10V3 to see if this made a difference. Sure enough, after over a year of being problematic, the problem finally seemed to be fixed. Or was it? Unfortunately, once I started a larger print, I began running into the same issues as before, although at least my print bed temperatures were correct this time. I will be posting the G code in the description below just in case it does end up working for you. Having seen a lot of issues with the wiring hubs of this machine, I will begin trying to rewire it in an effort to get the machine working properly. Make sure to keep an eye out for the follow-up video when I undergo this process, since I will be including a price breakdown as well. So was this repair worth it? I'd say yes, considering that the thermistors are fairly inexpensive nowadays, especially the ones which are compatible with the Anycubic printer. In case some of you are wondering, I bought the NTC3950 100K version at the time from Amazon. However, if you're worried about compatibility issues, and don't want to risk having to change the firmware settings, you may wish to order it from the main Anycubic website. If you liked this video, please feel free to subscribe, and should you wish to support more content like this, you can do so by visiting my online shop, which is in the description below. For those of you who may not know, I do live streams twice a week on Twitch, so make sure to keep an eye out for those if you're interested. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.